Right, so the next stage is we've saved it and we've published it, but we'll do that again for good measure. I can't save it because it's not a highlight, and I'm going to go publish again. And now, back into UDK, shut that down. Whoops. Don't save. Open a menu up, so we want to open that one, that's the one we're working on. Tutorial menu map, open. And then go into the editor, click on that, go right click. Now this box won't appear that I'm scrolling up and down now in my screen recorder, but it's here, believe me. Now you just check re-import, and it's telling us about that cursor error. I think it's because I didn't name the cursor PNG to import it, so it doesn't realise it's here. I mean, I'll work it out later. I might ask Mathew Doyle on the Epic Game forums how to get that error resolved. It's not important though, it all still works. So we've got it in the editor now, and then we go into, let's test out the map now and see if our start button's there. It is. Now the next thing to do is go escape. This will not work from the editor, by the way. Go into the Kismet, open up the GFX Movie Player, and notice it's still got GFX Movie Player selected, so now we're going to change that to Menu, which is our custom menu class that we've created. And notice in here I already have, oh yeah, I told you that in the last video, but so menu, that's all we're going to open it with. And then we'll shut that down. We will go save all now. And then the next step is go into your computer, UDK, config again. And this time default game. Now you have to reference that map. Now I'll show you quickly what I mean. Let's drop this down for the minute, the default game. What we'll do is we'll delete out the UDK game for the moment. Go delete. So go back now. No, forward, so that we're in the content directory. Now find the map you want to open. Sorry, no you don't. You have to use the menu map that you've created with the menu in it. So let's quickly show you what I mean. We've called ours test menu map. Well, I don't know what you've called yours, but this is what we've got to reference in the config file. Close that. Go open. Tutorial menu map UDK blah blah blah. This is the map that we've got to reference in the code now, so that it opens our menu up. Right, so escape that. Shut the editor again. And this is it here. So go rename. And just copy the first part, copy, don't rename it, and then go into the config file, and where it says default game equals Dave Saxon, sorry, no, we're in the wrong folder here, no, that's the default game, back into development, no, into config, I should say. Default engine, is it? It must be. Yeah, there it is. So this second paragraph, map extensions equals UDK, whatever. So we've got to paste in the name of that map here. Yours will be something like, I can't remember what it is, UT front end or something like that. But where it says map equals, paste in the name of your map there. Paste. And then obviously the UDK extension is already there, but if you've pasted over the whole line and your UDK extension's not there, just add that in again. because it needs to know what type of map to open, and then we paste it in there as well. And then here. And go paste. And that's it, done. And now we go save. But the only thing is, it's going to open up this ugly map that I've, or the ugly menu and not my pretty one I've been creating, but this is just for the tutorial anyway. So now it's time to boot up the engine, the game. So go into the UDK game now, and as I said a few videos back, the first window that will open, it will probably be, I've got to rebuild scripts, I think. No. So first window is a splash screen. Second window is a Bink movie. Excuse me, tutorials are on my website for that. And a link on my website to Bink, to Rad Game Tools, to download it. And there, here's our ugly menu with a start button, an options button and an exit button. Now, because we've defined a map in the code, when we press start now, that should, in theory, boot up my intro movie map. Let's go. Another Bink movie there. There you go. So it's booting up my map. Now, what we'll do is we'll exit out of here quickly. Ah, this is what I mentioned earlier on, it will not let me exit from here because I haven't set up the exit button yet. So what we're going to do is going to go Control-Alt-Delete. Start the task manager. Just so we can get rid of that window for the moment. Where's the... Ah, there. And now... We're going to close down some files for the moment. Not that one, I want that open. We want that open so as to delete out the UDK engine again in a little while. So the next thing to do is to open a different map now. So go computer, UDK, game, content, maps. See, these are the UDK maps to open. So let's do the example map now. Go rename, copy, and now we're going to go into the code now, our custom menu code development, src, my menu, classes, menu, and then right here paste that into our map to open. And go paste. Example map. Yeah, that should be it. Save, drop that down. Drop that down, and now just boot the editor up once because we've got to recompile scripts. Go, yep. Should come up with no errors and no warnings. Yep, it has. So shut the editor down and now go back into the game. Now it should boot up the it should boot up that example map and not our own map. See, whatever you've defined in that class, it'll open. There we go. Start. Give it a little while. It's just struggling a bit at the moment, just because this map needs a longer Bink movie to introduce it. And there you go, we're in. See, the bigger a map is and the more resources, the longer it will take to load. So that Bink movie, we could have had a Bink movie that was, say, 5 seconds or 10 seconds long. The one I use to open my map only needs to be 2 or 3 seconds long, and so that's why it ended up repeating itself, looping. Here you are, this is the example map. There's some robots down there running up and down in the sewers. They should be. They were in the last time I looked in this map. Yeah, well, they're in here somewhere. And this is a little test map. You can jump in that vehicle by pressing E. Oh, there's one there. Look, see him, Muggins? I can't remember how you work this stupid thing. Let's escape and go and batter him. These are just crowd agents. They're not actual proper bots. So they won't attack you. There is one in here, though. It'll end up being my character, though, because the default character in here is my character. Where is it, that lift? Go in here. Out here. Press that E. And then through the wall. And there we are, into the intro movie. If you've watched the 3D Buzz tutorials, you know how to set all this up. See, at the moment, because in the movie it's that bot thing, and there's my man. See? And we're in God mode at the moment, so we can't die. That's why my health is still 100. There you are, there's my man. That's for trying to shoot me. Right, there you go anyway. Exit. Takes us back here. See, the exit button doesn't work. That's what we want to set up. I've got the action script for it, but I haven't tested it yet. So that when we press that now, we leave this window. See, at the moment, we can't leave this window the normal way. So all I do to leave it at the moment is go Control-Alt-Delete. Task manager up, and then I can get outside of the window then and go start and then cancel the task manager. So that's it, tutorial 4. We've got a start button running, and we've got an options button to change a few of the internal options. The exit button's not running yet. Let's have a look at it in here. But they all highlight because we copied over the buttons. We've got the over and under, or the over and touch button effects by copying these buttons. And the cursor, see, it's left there on the, when we leave the screen, it's left in place. And there it is on here. Now what we're going to do is go in the timeline and lock every layer so that nothing can be accidentally moved. Or in the following video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the background image now and replace that with a PNG, which you can do as well, because then it will look like your own menu rather than one you've copied. And at the moment I'm working on changing the button images. If we look at those in here, go scenes, I think, yeah, they're under. So look at the library. All the button images are here somewhere. Label. Let's find them. Yeah, there you go. That, we want to get rid of that because I don't like it. And all the various levels of the button. See these things here, we'll change all those eventually to reference our own images. And there's just a lot of stuff in here. These are the buttons that are inside the menu, so we're not worried about them so much. The ones I want to change are that. Yeah, that one specifically, I want to change that. Now that button, it's got some different options with it. way. So you just scroll through. Now I think that's the button for when that's the no, these are the focus ones. Yeah, that one there, that's so when you're over it and you click it, it highlights around the button. We'll try and change that all eventually to suit our own button structure. But, oh yeah, these are internal buttons inside the menu. There's just so much stuff in this folder that it's worth going through and having a look at it all. Close that one down. Ah, these are our backgrounds for that button there, I think. But the easiest way to find out is to go into your UDK directory again. Computer, UDK, UDK game, Flash, tutorial skinned. Click tutorial skinned art assets and then go whack, open the lot up in Photoshop, go open and look through each button, because the button ones, that menu button that we were just looking at, has all its different over, under, or over, touch and different visual states as layers, so you can see it. That's the beauty of having of Adobe Flash sort of crossover to Adobe Photoshop. What, some text contains fonts? Yeah, so what? Come on. Ah, there you go, they're all opening now. Right, so let's try the first one. When it's finished loading, what we want is that menu button. It's in here somewhere. Oh my god, I didn't realise I meant menu button. There you go. And now there's its different layers there. The over, up and background. So let's lock that layer for the moment. There's the over. Lock that one. There's the up. Lock that, and there's the background. Let's lock. Let's unlock that, or I should say, not unlock it. What I'm doing is making it disappear, the layer. So that's the down state. That is the over state when your mouse cursor hovers over it. And then this one is the up state, I think, after you've let go of it. All clever stuff, though. The background there, I'm not quite sure what the point of that is. But there we go. So all you'd have to do now is change all these images in Photoshop to reference your stuff. Let's have a look, see what the image properties are. Image. No, edit. Oh god, where's the image properties gone again? Image size. Oh, they're in here somewhere, I can't remember where. But anyway, I'll worry about that in the next video. So this is what I want to change, so that I've changed the whole entire menu to look like my one. But what I'll do in the next video, I'll be working on my menu. Oh no, actually, I've got to change over the image first for you guys, just to show you how it's done. So we'll shut Photoshop. Don't save anything, no. We want to back into Flash.